How can you make a difference? What can be done to meet the needs of children in conditions so different from ours? Luckily, there is a hopeful, promising solution. Hope for Haiti's Children is an organization committed to serving the children less fortunate than us. Hope for Haiti does mission trips to Haiti, gives out food, digs wells, and provides education for children in need. They're able to do this through donations given by people just like you. By giving donations, sponsoring a child, sending joy boxes, and even more. People like you can give these children hope for the first time.
My name is Tanya Hunt. I'm the Vice President of Hope for Haiti's Children. So Hope for Haiti's Children has a sponsorship organization. We're a sponsorship organization. So what we do is we sponsor individual children to go to school through a U.S. sponsor. So about $36 a month will pay for that child to go to school. Without that, that child would not go to school. They would just be at home. They would be with their families. They'd start to garden. They would never learn to read and write. You know, the average income is less than $2 a day for a family. So you can see how a little bit goes a long way. Here in the U.S., I guess we take almost everything for granted. We've got clean water that comes out of a faucet that we have limitless supply of. We can take a shower at any time of the day. The cost for water is very, very low, and we can always rely that it's clean water that won't make us sick. The Haitian people do not have that. Clothing we take for granted, food we take for granted. They don't have access. A lot of our kids, even though we have a school lunch program in our schools, they get one meal a day. Getting food in Haiti is very, very difficult. There's not a lot of food that is produced in Haiti, so they're having to purchase it from the outside, and it's being imported in. There are some rice fields, there are some gardens, but it's not enough to feed the many, many people that live there. We're asking individuals in the United States to sponsor one child. So $36 a month will sponsor that child. Our guarantee is that 100% of those funds go to Haiti. We don't take a single penny of that money. We send it all to Haiti to educate the child. $36 pays for the uniform. It pays for the teachers to be paid. It pays for their backpack, for their books, and just everything that they need to be educated that year. A lot of these kids, they may eat one meal a day. Sometimes that's that one meal that they get at lunchtime. There's no guarantee that when they wake up in the morning that they're going to get to eat.
Providing hope is just a click away, and there is a simple way to do it. Go to their homepage and click the blue donate button. Then, simply choose whether you want to donate or sponsor a child in need. After choosing, simply fill out the amount you'd like to give, how often you wish to donate, and fill in your payment information. Hope for Haiti also gives donors the choice of where they would like their donation to go by clicking the designation. You can also choose to give in honor of someone and whether or not to notify that person of your donation. Then, click the black donate button at the bottom of the page, and you're done. You just made a big difference by helping a real family across the globe feel hope. These people need your help, and there's a way you can do it. Just donate today.
That's the first track. The second one is the case could be bound over to the adult court. So if you are 14 years or older and you commit a serious enough offense, the prosecutor's office could seek to have the case bound over to the adult court. And what we do is we have a hearing in juvenile court to see if it's a proper charge in which to treat the minor as an adult. And if that's the case, the case gets sent over to the adult court and they get tried as an adult. And at that point, I lose jurisdiction. That's the second track. The third one is a blend. And what I mean by that is I treat them as a juvenile to the extent that I want to, and then it kind of carries over into the adult world as more of a for lack of a better word, it's a threat. If you don't do what I'm telling you to do in the juvenile setting, when you turn 18, it's going to be transferred over to the adult court and you're going to have a second round of punishment.
Did you know some youth in Warren County report that their parents never talked to them about underage drinking?
The video that you're about to watch basically came about because of a blogger. This woman who lives just outside of Columbus was able to go online and look at all these social media sites. And I don't know the social media sites to be able to recite them today, but all I know is this. She was able to follow the participants' activities by their social media reports, and she pieced this thing together from scratch, probably from her living room. And so, if nothing else is taken from the people who are watching this video, take this. Everything you do on the internet, everything has a memory. It does not go away, always gets out. You cannot put that much faith and trust in sending something like that out. It never works. You've got to remember that that picture stays out there for somebody else to see. You think that it's gone, you think somebody's deleted it, it does not go away. So imagine, if you will, you want to get a scholarship or you want to get a job, and something that you said, something that you posted, something that you took a picture of and was sent on to somebody else now makes its way back to you, and you're at 25 years of age and all of a sudden it's coming back out and you're having to answer to that, all because you did not think through it when you were 15 years old and you did something stupid with your phone.
So in terms of